This is a short but very important video. It's called How to Use New Window. Yes, not new document, new window. Let's get started. Let's start with Word. Simple Word document open. Go to View tab, Windows, you see one document. Nothing special. But there is a new window button. Have you seen that button before? No. So click on it. Now again look at the list of windows. We still have one document open, but it has two windows. Same document is being shown in two separate windows. Now you'll say, what is the point? Why would I want to do that? Yes, very good question. Answer is, look at the document. I have a long document. And after finishing the document, I want to write the summary, executive summary. Generally, what will you do? Executive summary is in the beginning. You start writing, but then you don't know what you wrote. So you scroll below. Then think, this is what I want to write. Then again come up. Then write, again go down. So don't want to do that. What do? In one window, you stay in the beginning. And in the second window, you move wherever you want. Very nice. Yeah, but wait. You still have to shift between two windows. Oh, yes, you can do that with Alt Tab. I hope you know what is Alt Tab. So if you want to see them side by side, there is actually a button there called View Side by Side. You also try the Arrange All button. So if you have two monitors, one of the instances or window can be on this monitor, another on this monitor. Even better. Now, this need not be the same document. In fact, you can have two different documents. Maybe there's some little bit of change and you want to compare them. Then you can say View Side by Side and Synchronize Scrolling. So if you scroll this document, this one scrolls automatically. Another practical use of this is I am designing something which requires a layout or even a simple proposal. I want to know where the pages are breaking, how is the overall proposal. So I'm zooming out. But while I'm zooming out, I realize, I have to make some change there. And that's going to change all the pages. So again, new window. In one window, you're doing detailed changes. In other window, you can see the overall picture. Isn't that brilliant? So start using it. So in Excel, it's even better. Bahut log poochte hain, I have two sheets and I want to see both the sheets together. This is the answer. Let's try in Excel. There's one window right now. Create a second window. Now, when you say View Side by Side in Excel, it goes one below another. Not a good idea. I want Side by Side. So now what do? Go to Arrange All. And there is a button called Vertical. But wait, do not click OK. There is a very important checkbox there. Windows of Active Workbook only. And now you choose Vertical. Now you can see one sheet here, one sheet here. Amazing. And if you really want, you can have two different sheets also. And there is simultaneous scrolling. So if you scroll here, you can scroll there. Isn't that brilliant? Try it out immediately. Well, when will you really use it? Well, when you have details somewhere and you're looking at summary somewhere else. That's obvious. Second, you have data in one sheet and the charts are in another sheet or the dashboard. And you're changing something and you want to see the impact. Many people want to use this for comparison. It's an obvious use case, but wait. For comparison, there is an even better tool available called Inquire. I've created a detailed video on that. If you want to compare something, if you want to audit something, do not do this. Use Inquire. Now let's come to PowerPoint. PowerPoint is a different ballgame because it has two faces. One is a master layout and slides. So very, very important. I'm going to change something in the layout master and I want to see how my slides look when I do that. Most people change the master first, then go to normal view, then they see what happened. Array, this is not right. Again, go back and change. No, new window. In one window, you are editing the master and in the other window live, you are seeing the results. In fact, if you're doing some global changes to the master, in the other window, you keep it in slide sorter view. There you can see not just impact on one slide, but the entire presentation. There's an amazing use of new window for PowerPoint. The second one, PowerPoint can be very detailed. So I'm creating a very complex slide and I want to see in detail exactly pixel by pixel adjustment. But at the same time, I also want to see how the slide looks overall. How do I do that? New window. In this case, in one window, you have seen the whole slide. In the other window, you are seeing detailed version of the slide by zooming in on individual shapes. So that is how you use new window to your advantage. Of course, it's available in OneNote as well. And now let's talk about Outlook. In Outlook also, we have new window option. Now, why would you want to do that? For task management and many other things. Oh, I hope you have seen my task management video. It gives you all the best practices about how to manage your work and project-specific work. Have a look. One of the use cases there is my tasks are in task folder. But my time to execute the task cannot be blocked in task folder. It has to be in calendar. So go to calendar, you are seeing the calendar. But I also want to see the task. So right-click on task, open in new window. So like that, wherever there is same context but multiple views, then you create a new window. I'm sure you have got the idea, and you will find new places, new scenarios where to use new window as well. So you know what to do. Oh, it looks like most of you don't know what to do because 79% people are non-subscribers. So why don't you subscribe first and then click on the bell icon, share this with your colleagues, and watch this video about which Microsoft app to use when. So till next time, take care. Bye-bye.